But meanwhile, the ruling National Democratic Congress says government is feverishly working to address the current power crisis, contrary to claims by the opposition NPP.
Addressing a news conference in reaction to the NPP's Wonbo demonstration, the party insisted the opposition should rather offer alternatives to resolving the power crisis.
If you look at the levels of additions, the number of signings, and the commitment to long-term energy solution, then they cannot really match us. That is why we are surprised. A building is commenced, the building reached a footing level, you had opportunity to come and add, you never add a single block. Today, another person has come to continue the building, it has reached the roofing level, you can see planks on the building for roofing to take place, and you are demonstrating and complaining, why is it that they have not roofed the building so you can live inside?
The leadership of the NDC insisted the opposition must be willing to offer alternative solutions to resolving the energy crisis instead of hitting the streets.
Why demonstrate against something you contributed significantly to putting us in? And like we kept asking the MPP, give us any alternative that you think this government is not doing today to deal with the problem, or give us something that you did different or that you did so well when you had 8 years.
The party revealed they had a secret recording of a senior member of the NPP, Yao Osafumafo, inciting ethnic sentiments. They called on Ghanaians to condemn the act, noting his comment had the tendency of creating acrimony amongst the various ethnic groupings.
In light of the grave nature of this comment and its potential to undermine national unity, we call on Mr. Osafumafo to render an unqualified apology to all Ghanaians for hurting our sensibilities in this manner with his unguided comments. We also call on the leadership of the NPP to take stern action against Mr. Osafumafo and others who beat a similar path.